whatever, now I gotta go deal with it. Whatever, that's fine.
Hi guys, subscribe our channel and press the bell icon for never miss the update.
Hey guys, TN Electronics here with a great new video. So today I'll be doing an unboxing of, as stated on the Mercari listing that I bought, it says it is a really messed up iPhone 6. And I kind of just went for it and bought it since it was only $200, and apparently the only problem with it is there's a crack on the screen. He had no ratings, so I was a little sketched out. And he has no comments or anything. He's a completely new seller, but I kind of just bought it just to see how it ended up. So I'm going to be doing an unboxing of it right now. So like I said, supposedly all it's supposed to be is a cracked iPhone 6. With no problems, just cracked screen. So let's go ahead and open it. It's a kind of a sketchy packaging. It doesn't seem like there's really any tissue or anything in it, so let's go ahead and open it. Okay. Seems good so far. So far, iPhone. It's supposed to be gold, and I don't know if you guys can see, but it is gold coloring. And it says 16 gigabyte. Which is it's supposed to be. For some reason, they took off the sticker that shows the IMEI and everything. A little sketchy, but whatever. So let's go ahead and open it. Okay, nothing on the top. No manuals. But at least, I was a little scared there, but apparently there is an iPhone in here. With no accessories. So far, it locks. With an empty manual case and an iPhone 6 itself. So it does look like stated in the picture. Pretty good condition. It's got some wear and tear on the sides. A little dent there in here. and the shattered screen. So let's go ahead and turn it on, or let's hope it turns on. That's a good sign. I thought for sure something was going to be different from the listing, but I guess not so far. So let's just wait for it to turn on. iPhone 6 in gold, 16 GB. Bought it for $200 on Mercari. And I showed in one of my previous videos what Mercari is. It's like an eBay without fees. I'll put a thing, a URL in my description. So it is working. Look at that. See, they didn't restore it or anything. Or they did restore it, but I didn't have to do the activation screen, which I usually have to do. There's no iCloud on it, which I thought would be the problem. I thought there would still be an iCloud block. No service, which means they still have a SIM card in it, but they deactivated the SIM card. It is AT&T. And let's make sure Siri works. That's how I check if the speakers work and the microphone. Okay, so it's saying she doesn't have internet. Which apparently she does.
I seem to have lost my internet connection.
That's a little scary.
Sorry, I seem to have lost
my internet. So it seems that Siri is not working, even though I have full bars on Wi-Fi right now. So maybe that's a problem. I think everything else, it seems, other than that, let's make sure typing works. Typing works perfectly. Siri still doesn't work. Okay, guys, so it seems like I got a pretty good deal, $200. If I fix the screen, I can sell it for about $600. So I'm pretty happy with this purchase. Maybe I can get Siri working sooner or later.
Hey, guys, what's going on? It's Yoanthi. Today I have a new sneaker unboxing. I honestly forget what it is. I have, like, a bunch of stuff coming in. And this apparently came in a replacement box, so now I'm like trying to rack my brain because I picked a bunch of things up off eBay, but I didn't think anything came with a replacement box, so I don't know, and they didn't even put the replacement box in a box, so they just used some old Timberland box, and then just printed right on it, so I don't know, let me peek in, what the hell, let's see here, this box is probably gonna be trashed anyways. Kind of useless. Oh, never mind. So there is a Jordan box. I was gonna say, I thought everything I got had the original box, so let's take a look at what these are. I forget which ones they are. Alright, cool. Air Jordan, what you guys guess? What model? Oh, cool, we got a receipt too. Alright, Air Jordan 9 Cool Gray. Grabbed them off eBay, however, I think they're a little more worn than I would have liked. Here we go, Air Jordan 9 Cool Grays. I paid $120 shipped for these. $120 shipped. They look way more worn than I thought in the photo, so this might be one of those, you know what I mean? Like, sometimes I get lucky, but nah, these are worn way, way too much. I'm not happy with the condition. I guess I should have asked for better photos. Because based off the photos, they looked okay, but you can tell these have been worn a lot. Like, you can tell in there, even on the insides, their insides are kind of gross. So this is a case where, you know, I should have asked for closer up pictures, because like from far away, like when you see it like that, the shoe itself, it looks pretty clean, but I didn't realize how much they were worn. They look kind of gross, you know what I mean? Yeah, these, they even smell bad too. This is it's going to be a fail. I've got lucky on a few. I've gotten mainly lucky on Jordan Retros. However, these, I'm not happy with the condition, so I'll probably email, you can tell they've been worn a lot, so I'll probably email the kid and just see if we can do a swap back, or I'll just try to move them, but yeah, I'm not happy with these ones. I should have done, I wasn't too concerned either. I was like, whatever, cool grays for 120, I'll grab them, I don't even care. I should have looked at the photos a little closer, but that's fine. Where are they from? Alright, whatever, that's fine. So this is, I guess, a good lesson for the people that buy off eBay. Make sure you always ask for close-up photos so you can kind of see what you're working with. But I'm not feeling those. Because if I'm going to buy a retro that's been worn, I only want it to be worn, you know, 1 to 3 times. And the last couple I've gotten have been in pretty good shape, whereas these... The last couple I've gotten have been in pretty good shape, but these just not cutting it for me. So this is always like a struggle, because now I'm going to have to go hop back on eBay, see if the kid will do a return. If he won't do a return, then I'll have to move him. But I don't even know that. I don't even think that these are not worth 120. Those in that condition. These are worth like 90 bucks maybe. So I just want to give you guys that unboxing. Always disappointing when you get something in. The pictures looked way cleaner. So it's always disappointing when you get something in and you're kind of like pumped for it and then you're like, ugh. So, fail on the Cool Grey 9s. I'm still looking for a pair size 8.5 or 9 if anyone has them. So yeah, these will be going back. So, as always, guys, thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed the video. Kind of, you know, such a letdown. Usually I get really excited, but this pair wasn't feeling it. Nah. Whatever. Now I gotta.